Hey, Sergeant Hale, First Rangers.
An American? We thought the Chimera stopped all of you in York.
Chimera?
Those creatures. Oh, you jammed it. I'm sorry, Hale. Looks like you'll have to find your own way out. I'll be in touch. Frequency 77.6. It was strange enough that a lone American soldier was walking around a Chimeran conversion center, but it was his eyes that were most disturbing. They showed unmistakable Chimeran traits. It was subtle, but it was there. Whoever Nathan Hale was, he wasn't entirely human. conversion center was built on top of an old fish cannery. Networks of tubes transported the bodies from one stage of conversion to another. Once humans are infected by the Chimeran virus, they fall into a coma. The virus begins changing their bodies from the inside out, eventually turning them into one of the Chimeran creatures. The conversion centers simply speed up the process.
Sergeant Hale, come in. I'm seeing more hybrid patrols now. They must know we've escaped. Be careful.
During the second phase of the conversion process, the humans are wrapped in cocoons. This accelerates the final stages of the conversion. What emerges from the cocoon is determined by the strain of the virus. Each Chimeran creature is created by a separate strain. What we call hybrids, the ones that most closely resemble humans, have the shortest gestation period. The more beastly creatures take months to create, and are made from multiple human bodies. final stage of the Chimeran conversion process is known as the birthing chamber. The cocoons are opened and new Chimera are born. In the case of hybrids, a cooling apparatus is fused into their bodies. The Chimeran metabolism is roughly 12 times that of humans. This results in remarkable healing abilities, but also raises their body temperatures significantly. Without the cooling apparatus, the hybrids would overheat and die.
Thank you.
blocking your only route out.
We'll be right back.
I was able to make it to the surface and summon a rescue. Flying into the Chimeran territory was always dangerous, but we had to risk it. Hale made it out shortly after. I looked for any further signs of conversion. Fever, nervous movement, paranoia. There was nothing. Just the gold-colored eyes. We flew directly to Manchester. Soldiers had been trying to recover the convoy ever since my squad was ambushed. They knew what was in it. They knew it was our last hope for defeating the Chimera. I wanted to take Hale back to Northern Command for debriefing. Maybe he could sense I was suspicious of him. He joined the Manchester squad before I could say a word.